Hello, this is Broyar, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play EU4 as the Duchy of Brittany. One of the things I'm going to do real quick, we're currently specialized in admin, which is fine, and it got us caught up a little bit. We're still behind on just about everything. Some of that's because we don't have the institution at the moment, among other things. So one thing I am going to do, though, is since we still have a little bit of idea stuff for diplomacy to fill out, as well as that's the one that we're the furthest behind on currently, I think I'm going to go ahead and just specialize in Diplo for a bit. And by a bit, I guess I mean, 25 years? but I think that's going to be fine. It's going to get us caught back up on that. There's a lot of trade stuff, obviously, within the Diplo side of things, which, you know, it's going to be very key to our continued growth. So I think specializing that is going to be a fine move. I just realized that we are both improving our relations as well as building a spy network with the Arawak, which makes absolutely no sense. So we're going to get rid of that at the very least. If I remember right, we were at the end of the last episode, we were trying to figure out why we couldn't declare war here, or why we couldn't, no, it's not declare war, why we couldn't, what was it? Oh, fabricate a claim, that's right. No possible neighboring province to fabricate a claim on. Which doesn't make sense to me. Because we're right here. Why can we not fabricate right there? We're actually all surrounding you completely. So I'm not sure what that's referring to. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to unpause. And we'll go see what the war declaration things are available there. We might actually send our other Diplo over here to start working on some of this stuff. Maybe we can go after this guy next. Does he have any? Doesn't look like he has anybody that he knows about. So that might be a good guy that we can maybe annex this guy or something like that. To kind of expand our reach a bit more. Possibly at some point come after the Cato up here. The Cato. That might be worth something. But anyway, let's go ahead and unpause. And okay, there's our diplomat. I'm just going to go ahead and look while he's here. We're not going to do it, I don't think, yet. Oh. We already had a CB there. Well, then I'm just going crazy. Did we get that CB from... do we have a mission for that? Am I just, like, completely going crazy? I am. We got the Arawak, which means we've already got the mission, which means I've been wasting my time this whole time, and I'm being silly. Okay. Well, we're going to go ahead and take that. And I think that is going to be perfectly fine. We probably should increase our maintenance on our military before we do that, though. Even though it is only 3K, it's probably bad to go in there with zero maintenance. I'm just going to look over. There we go. Let's go ahead and boost our army maintenance all the way up. Once that comes into play, then we'll go ahead and declare war and go after this guy. In the meantime, you can come over here and... Obviously, we can't declare war on this guy yet, but we can start building a spy network on this guy. And maybe that could be another target for us soon. Got a couple more ships coming out, so that's going to be good. All right, one more month would be fully moraled up, basically. Mostly full. I think we're technically at, like, what, 90-something, probably? Yeah, close enough. He's only got 3K troops. Probably could have done it before this, but that's going to be all right. So now... We can't declare war on you because we're currently building a spy network, so we'll go ahead and come back from that. We're not going to need that at all. And declare war. Sorry, dude. We have a quest for you. Other reasons. You're going to have to go. There's that. We'll take the province, and all will be well. So we got disloyal states. States demand control of provinces with the clergy. I think the reason we hadn't done that is because their influence is high, which is correct. That will be going away in 5 years. So that's going to be troublesome, but we'll deal with it as it comes. So I got some provincial unrest. Let's take more, another idea group. Which something in the military would probably be good. I was kind of leaning towards quality because it would kind of help our ship stuff a bit more, which, you know, can't go wrong with that. Or naval ideas. Actually, that might be interesting. Hey, heavy ship combat ability. I mean, we're going to have a lot of Navy, so ship durability, stuff like that. I mean, that's our fighting force for a lot of this. I mean, we're going to be able to do some, you know, land type stuff down here, but there's a lot of that going as well. We don't have any policies we can add, do we? Global tariffs. We should actively impose additional taxes on our colonial settlements. I don't think we actually... Are these count as colonial settlements? Or does it count... Are these the colonial settlements? I'm not actually sure what the tariffs refers to. Well, once we finish the trade ideas, we can go ahead and take the statute of... Does that say monopolies? It looked like it had an A or something in there, but yeah. Statute of monopolies, so we can go after that at some point. Embrace the Counter-Reformation. Form the French nation. Huh. Yeah, I don't think we're going to be doing that anytime soon. Admin tech of at least 6. Catholicism gains some reform desire. We get more national tax modifier and missionary strength. Yeah, burnable to own the Bible, that seems a little excessive to me. A lot excessive, actually. All right, let's go ahead and unpause, get this going. We do have a diplomat free. We're going to need him here in a moment anyway, so we'll be fine. Could take another idea over here. Trade steering. But I think saving up for this tech is going to be fine. More trade efficiency, stuff like that, and that's going to be good for us. How many lights do we have now? We got, what, 40, 37? It's not too bad. I want to get as many heavies as England has, just to kind of be able to fend ourselves. I guess we could have saved some stuff to not send 19,000 people over there. Oh well, we're already there now. It's gonna be fine. That attrition. We've almost got it now, though. Come on, 49% chance. Really? Let's go. Wow, we cannot get this thing to flip. There we go. Alright, so now we can go piece you out. And yeah, we might as well just absorb you. It's going to be fine. Get all your money, everything else. It's going to be alright. We could have, like, annexed you or something, but... Or made you a vassal, but don't know if that's really what we're looking for. And honestly, we actually have the mission for that, so that's going to be the best course of action. More yearly prestige. Can't go wrong with that. Let's make you a core. Mission selected. Turn Verwegas into a city. Well, that's going to happen anyway. Prove legitimacy. I would love to get that. We are getting a lot more legitimacy now, so that is good. We're still losing prestige, but as our legitimacy comes up, no, actually. Yeah, not really. It's the cores and stuff like that that's hurting us, as well as... we just got low prestige. But the legitimacy will start bouncing back, which is going to be good. Turning this into a city is, I think, going to make sense, because that's going to happen no matter what we do. Build provincial improvements. Let's do that. Still need to embrace the... institution. Still quite a ways away, so I think I'm okay with just letting that spread out a little bit more, and for now go ahead and continue to work on our economy some more. Speaking of economy, how are we at on the force limit? 50 of 51. Do we have any more ships being built? We don't at the moment. I mean, I did say I do want more heavies. Other thing is to start upgrading some of these guys at some point as well. So we have 3 heavies at the moment. How many heavies do other competitors have? Probably tons. Navies, heavy ships. Ming has 27. Thankfully, they're probably not going to be anything we have to worry about. Literally, of this list, the only ones I'm really worried about is Great Britain. He's got 20 heavies. We are a long ways before we get caught up with that. 140 naval force limit. That is insane. absolutely insane. I mean, look, troops, the ships he's got running around here have got 16 heavies. Yeah, we can't compete with that. Not anytime soon. So, I don't know. I mean, the more heavies we get, the sooner we can start competing with that. Goodness, that's insane. I think we're just, let's keep doing some lights. I mean, we got to keep increasing our financial standing. And I think that's going to be fine. Let's go ahead and click you to go home at time of war. And I think that's going to be fine. All right, other than that, though, building some stuff. That's 10. 10. Well, by saying 10, they're 0.1, obviously. Marketplace. Building a couple of these in some of the places that have the... already have the trade power stuff. Might be beneficial. Such as... Is that one right there? Okay, well, I think that's one, right? I didn't really mean to click on it like that. Yeah, that is. Okay. Coastal Center Trade. Well, that's fine. That's going to be a fine one to do. I should have just like checked this before I clicked on the buildings, but that one's one. There's a couple down here. Definitely, I think getting those trade centers in each of those places will be beneficial, increasing our trade power in the Caribbean, because... This is going to be a pretty solid node, I believe, overall, once we get it developed even more. Do we have an opportunity to send any further down, by any chance? Oh, a great advisor has died. It's our Diplo guy. I guess global tariffs is fine, just to get something going. Does not look like we can send any further down, I don't think. Yeah, we're already sitting from here. This one's too far away. This one's too far away. Even Mexico's too far away, which is a little wild. I have no idea why there's a beep going off. Everything else looks fine. Wow. I think my wife is cooking something, and it apparently is smoking up the house a little bit. So I apologize for that. I'll try to mute between sentences so that you don't have to hear that. Yeah, I mean, we can come all the way to Chesapeake Bay, Gulf of St. Lawrence, things like that. But, none of those will steer down towards us, so I don't think there's any benefit there. I think really our best benefit's gonna be coming down into South America and start kind of making sure some of this stuff steers back towards our direction. So, we'll see how it goes. Let's see, anything else we want to change? I don't think so. I think we're good. Where are we at on this guy? 12. And military, you can actually... Well, for now, I'll just come back over here. And we are going to lower our maintenance again. Oh, there goes our good military leader. Well, no, wait a minute, that's not him. Maybe it was our naval guy. I guess for now, we can go ahead and mothball you guys as well. Just to save a little bit of money there. Do have some separatists popping up. Moron and Camagüey. Where are those guys? Camagüey's there. Moron's there. Yeah, actually, we probably should. If that gets up to 80%. We probably should just ferry our guys over there. How big would that one be? Let's see. It's the peasants. Only 11k. That's not too bad. We can deal with that. Actually, start moving you guys over here to Cartagena, whatever, so we can get ready to go after this dude. But I guess I should have increased your stuff before I did that, because you could have gotten jumped by some natives. That would have been silly. So probably what, 2 more months? 3 more months. Countries with which to hire Condottieri. Native assimilation in Coro. Nice. Getting that one almost done. Can invest in new technology. Diplo. Yeah, I think this is fine. Getting a little more trade range, getting some more trade efficiency. I think all that's going to be good. Trade range is only 280, though. Goodness. It's crazy. I'm guessing that does not open up any of this down here. Oh, it does. Why did it look like it was a lot, like it was going to take a lot more than that? Not sure. That's weird. So, and then on that note, probably shift this one over just because we can, like, I guess, daisy chain them a bit. I think they get a stacking like bonus if we do that. Although currently all of it's coming to us, isn't it? Let's see. What are we at right now? We're at 11.02. That's pretty good. Transfer trade power from the guy that's in Amazonas. It's going to take him a little bit to get there. But we'll see where we're at here shortly. So drop down a little bit before he got there. We are able to get our claim. What am I looking for? Fabricate claim. We'll go for Tunja. It's going to be fine. And we can now declare war on you. Or can we not? Do I let a day go by? I was going to say, I was like, wait a minute. I know we have this. Take Tunja. Yes. And I think we're just probably going to vassalize these guys. They're pretty big. I mean, we could suck them, absorb them all in. But, you know, why not? Let's get a vassal. At some point, Diplo annex them or something like that. Deal with their own rebel problems, things of that nature. Let's go ahead and... not what I want. I want to grab you. Detach. Move down. You actually have a fort down here. Impressive. Detach. Move down. Create export... or grant export licenses. When the crown could not or would not pay to the nobles, pay cash to the nobles, they would instead grant them privileges to collect special revenues. So their Cato's opinion of us goes up. We lose some legitimacy, which I really don't want to do. Do gain some tax modifier. Or alternatively, we can gain some legitimacy, which would be nice. Nobility loses some loyalty. Not so great. Bourgeoisie goes up. But it's okay. Cato's opinion goes down. What is your opinion of us at the moment? I want to look for it there. I mean, increasing this by 20 is not going to get us any closer to, like, diplo or, like, annexing you or vassalizing you diplomatically or anything like that. So I think I'm going to get our legitimacy. It's kind of actually like this one better. But losing legitimacy is so bad. So, so bad. It's lowering our income. Well, that's not really hurting us that much. Diplo rep a little bit. The national unrest is not so good. No, I just feel like this is better. We're going to eat it or whatever. All right, so you're there. If I split you off, can I just go after these guys? What do I have left? 7? And this is mountains. No, we're not going to do that. We'll just group up and we'll just sit here. Ooh, colony self-sustaining, perfect. Turn Veraguas, whatever, into a city. Go ahead and make you a core. And grab another mission. Accumulate money. Take us a little bit, but we could do that. Get us some prestige. Yeah, let's do that. Accumulate money. Well, that's going to be fine. Aww. Catherine has died. Is that our heir, really? Ah, we had a female heir. That's kind of cool. I mean, not cool that she died, obviously. But cool that we had one. So, do we not have a consort, really? Well, in that case, let's get us a marriage. What am I looking for? Royal marriage, nobody. Maybe because we're at war at the moment? Well, let's see if we can get through the war quickly. Oh, we lost our leader. Let's see if we can get another guy real quick. Military. Could we get one from you without putting us over some limit? Grant generalship, we'll get him. Yeah, we can do that. That should be fine. Oh, wow. A lot of fire on this guy. Yeah, this stuff's not amazingly great, but the fire is really good. Oh, I can't give it to you because you don't currently have... You're not in one of our territories. Let's give you the leader. And we're going to run you down to here. We may split off the siege enough to siege and go after this guy or something. To love and to be loved. A new consort appears. A royal marriage is really a matter of love. Rather, it is a diplomatic opportunity which is not to be wasted. So apparently we're in love, though. 1-2-4 is not great. Does lower national unrest, though. And then Llanos gets less local unrest, more productivity. But St. Martin gets displeased. We do lose some legitimacy. What? Really? But I feel like we got to marry for love. Come on now. That's good, right? Eh, let's do it. Maybe not statistically the right choice, but come on. It plays with the story. We gotta marry for love when we can. Actually, we don't have to go after your military. I'm actually going to leave them alone because once we vassalize you, you'll be able to have the military to defend yourself a little bit. Oh, that is a terrible error. Oh, such a bad error. Yeah, we're going to turn you into general as soon as we can. Maybe you'll at least be good at that. Probably not. Gain some base manpower in Charlefort. That's good. I got that siege over with, and there we go. Done. All right, let's go ahead and take you. We are going to make you a vassal. We are going to take your money, though, just because we can. All right, you can be my vassal. Done. Good stuff. Nobility demands stricter sumptuary laws. Less trade efficiency. Nobility and bourgeoisie... Or no, nobility gains influence, bourgeoisie goes down, and they lose loyalty, which would not be great. On the other side, a nobility losing some loyalty would not be great as well. And we definitely... Oh yeah, the nobility cannot gain influence, so we have to go with this one. I kind of like this one better anyway because we don't want to lose the trade efficiency. It's not great, but that's going to be a better option overall for us. Alright, so we got us a vassal. Carol's about to pop over to be a colony. Cores are, you know, getting there. Everything else looks good. Let's go ahead and move you, kind of bring you back. We'll send you out here after something else more productive momentarily. Oh, we never actually looked at our trade issue. 10.92, so it's maybe a tiny bit worse. Of course, that can also just fluctuate as, you know, time goes by, so it's about the same. Whether we do that or we go after the Amazonas. There's France. You've only got two heavies, so maybe we could send up to you at some point. All right, we're going to put a cut in here. I feel like we're making some decent progress. We're growing our lands and things like that. So far, so good. I do appreciate you watching, though, and I hope you join me again next time. Thank you, and goodbye.